Thanks, Jana. Investigators announced new developments today in a cold case of a 10-year-old girl who was found murdered in Western Mass.
Now they're asking for the public's help in identifying a key piece of evidence. Western Mass News reporter Paris Dunford joining us live in studio tonight with the latest details. Paris?
Chris, Mary, it's been nearly 30 years since Holly Piirainen was abducted from a family vacation in Sturbridge. A few months later, her body was found in Brimfield. Today, investigators say one article of clothing may help lead them to the killer.
The family would really, really appreciate some closure.
The aunt of Holly Piirainen pleading with the public for help. Her 10-year-old niece went missing back on August 5th of 1993, nearly 30 years ago. Holly was vacationing with her father and other family members in Sturbridge.
She was last seen by her father at about 11:45 a.m., heading toward a residence around Allen in South Shore Roads in Sturbridge to play with puppies she knew were at a home.
About 1 hour later, she was reported missing. A few months from that date, on October 23rd, her remains were found by hunters in a wooded area in Brimfield. On Wednesday, investigators released photos of this white tank top with purple, pink, and blue letters that read Boston on the front. They say this shirt was discovered in the area where Holly's body was found, and it's part of the case items found in 1993 that are undergoing further forensic testing. Investigators hope, with the public's help, this shirt will help lead them to answers.
We are interested in determining who owned the shirt, its origin, or places where it was known to be sold, anything about its manufacture, or any information regarding its association with the area where Holly was found in the Five Bridge Road area of Brimfield.
Hammond District Attorney Anthony Galluni tells Western Mass News there are no tags on the shirt that would indicate a size or a manufacturer. However, he says it appears to be an adult-sized shirt. In 2012, they identified a dead man, David Pouliot from Springfield, as a person of interest in this case after DNA evidence tied to him was found near where Holly was found. In 2020, investigators received a tip that led them to the grave of another man who would have been 18 at the time of Holly's murder. His remains were exhumed in search of a letter that may be tied to this case. When asked about these two men, Galluni says it's still an open investigation and there are persons of interest in this case, but he cannot identify who they are. Jackman, while standing next to her husband and Holly's grandmother, describes who she believes Holly would be today, as she would have just turned 40 this past month.
In my mind, she would have been confident and strong. I think she would have had a bright future, just pursuing whatever she decided. She's strong-willed.
The DA's office has set up a tip line dedicated to Holly's case. If you know any information about her disappearance, her murder, or about that tank top we showed you, you are urged to call the number here on your screen, 413-426-3507. Now, coming up tonight at 6, we speak with the family of Molly Bish, whose murder is another cold case that's still left with no answers. Reporting live in studio, Paris Dunford for Western Mass News.